goodnight, Christmas tree. In a snowy forest full of tall trees, there was one small tree. This little tree was different. It wasn't tall or wide, but it had a big wish. Every night, it looked up at the twinkling stars and wished, "I want to be a special Christmas tree." Not too far away, in a small village, lived a kind carpenter named Mr. Woodman with his family. Their house was small, but it was filled with love and laughter. Christmas was coming, and the village was getting ready. There were lights and songs everywhere, but Mr. Woodman felt a little sad. He wanted to make this Christmas special for his family, but he didn't have much money. Then, he had a wonderful idea. "Let's go to the forest and find a Christmas tree," he said to his family. Mr. Woodman, his wife, and their two children, Lily and Jack, put on their warm coats and set off into the forest. They walked and walked until they found the little tree. It was not like the other big trees. It was small and simple. "This one is perfect," Lily said with excitement. Mr. Woodman raised his axe, but then something amazing happened. The little tree spoke, "Please don't cut me down. I want to be your happy Christmas tree." Mr. Woodman was surprised to hear the tree talk. He smiled and said, "Yes, you will be our special Christmas tree." They carefully dug up the little tree and took it home. Back at their house, the family started to decorate the little tree. They used what they had: strings of popcorn, paper stars, and shiny buttons. Jack placed a little angel on top. The little tree felt so happy and loved. When Christmas Eve came, they lit small candles on the tree. The candles made the little tree glow. It looked so beautiful. People walking outside saw the light from the window. They came to see and were amazed by the little tree. They said, "It's small, but it's so beautiful and bright." The little tree realized that being special wasn't about being the biggest. It was about bringing joy and love. That Christmas was the happiest time for the little tree and the Woodman family. They sang songs and shared stories around the tree. There was so much laughter and joy. After Christmas, Mr. Woodman kept his promise. He replanted the little tree in the forest. Every year, the family visited the tree. The little tree grew a bit each time, but it always remembered that special Christmas. The little tree became known in the village. People would come to the forest to see it. They remembered the story of the small tree that brought so much happiness. Years passed, and the little tree grew taller. But it never forgot the Christmas it spent with the Woodman family. Every Christmas, before going to bed, the kids in the village would look out their windows at the forest and say, "Good night to the Christmas tree, the little tree that brought us the biggest joy."